Hello, my beautiful intermediate queens. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Stacy, and I'm so excited that you guys decided to come back and join me for part two of yesterday's video, where we were basically talking about my fitness journey, the fact that I've lost 83 pounds. So we'll recap really quickly about what we talked about yesterday. But stop, if you have not watched the first video, go back and watch the first video and then come to this one, because I'm going to reference a lot of what I said in the last video in this video. So please make sure you go back and watch that and then come back to this video. But basically, I was just telling you guys how I've lost 83 pounds from 2016 until now. It's taken me a long time because I wasn't really understanding the process and everything that it took to lose that amount of weight. And so I decided to make this two-part video special for you guys, just to give you a realistic expectation of what to expect when you're losing weight, and just to give y'all the real of like what actually goes down in the gym and outside of the gym when you are trying to have major results like I am. So just know that if I can lose 83 pounds, you definitely can lose 83 pounds or more or less or whatever your goal is. But just know that it is possible to do it. I'm proud of you. I'm rooting for you. I'm just really excited to get into the second part of this video of the remaining things that I wanted to tell you guys and share with y'all about what happens when you're on this weight loss journey. I wanted to start with this, and this is probably going to be the most unexpected realization of this fitness journey, which is 90% of the time, you're not gonna wanna work out. That is just me keeping it real. There are days where I'm putting on my workout clothes and my workout shoes and I'm like, I don't want to do this. I don't feel like going to the gym. It's so important to have a reason and a why and to know what your motivation is, because when you don't feel like it, that's what you have to dig to. That's what you have to pull out of your back pocket, and you have to remind yourself of why you're doing this. And so for me, I have a specific goal in mind, and that is what my reminder is, and that is what my motivation is. Not only my specific goal, but just to be healthy and to feel good and to feel just as good as I do on the outside as I do on the inside. And or to look as good as I feel on the inside, because I feel pretty darn good. You know what I mean? Your girl's been in therapy. She's living her best life. She's letting her inner glow shine out. But the one thing that always seems to be an issue for me was my weight. And it was one of those obvious things, you know? And so it was just like, okay, to me, this is one of the last things that I really need to tackle. So let me just get to it. And did that, and so proud of the results that I've seen. But it wasn't without me having moments of like, I really don't know if I want to continue doing this. And that's all the time. So just know that if you are somebody that's already on your fitness journey and you're feeling like that, that's normal. There's nothing wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with feeling like you don't want to do it. Where it becomes an issue is when you decide not to go to the gym, or when you decide not to meal prep or not to continue on this journey and being consistent. Because the thing about it is, consistency yields results, period. I don't care what meal prep your trainer gives you, what workouts he gives you or she gives you, what you're doing in between that, what supplements you're taking, any of those things. If you are not consistent with this and doing this the same thing every day or every other day, you're not gonna see results. And that's just me keeping it real. And so, yeah, there are gonna be days where you really, like, I'm pretty much sore. Oh, that's the other thing. I'm sore all the time. My muscles hurt literally every day of the week. And there's probably maybe like 2 or 3 days where I'll get like a little bit of a break or a little bit of a rest. But yeah, I'm like weight lifting. And every week my trainer is adding on more weights. He's adding more exercises. And I'm like, huh, you want me to do what? And so it's difficult. It's hard. But at the end of the day, I'm seeing the results. And so I'm still in a place where I don't want to quit, because I've come too far at this point. It would be foolish of me to quit. As a matter of fact, I was in the gym today earlier with my trainer, and it was leg day, and he went super crazy. Like, he really ramped it up this week, mainly because we're about to again transition into another, like, I guess, phase of our workout in the next couple of weeks. Me and my workout partner Ashley. Hey, Ashley. So it was crazy. And he was like, well, you cannot do this, or you can always quit. And I just kind of shot him a look like, yeah, right, I'm not gonna quit. Because at this point, I can't afford to quit. I've already had so much invested in, so much at stake. I want to see this all the way through to the end, and I'm going to. So I cannot wait till I'm watching this video 6 months from now, and I'm like, oh my God, like, I said I was going to stick to it, and I did. 9 times out of 10, you're not going to feel like doing it. You're not going to feel like working out, and you have to push through. You have to love the results more than you hate working out. Another thing that nobody tells you for real, is that working out is only 1/5 of it. It's like only like one, so think of a, like I want you to think of like a pie graph, right? And separate that into like 5 different sections. So working out is just one of those sections. Cause everybody thinks it's just working out and it's eating right. Ah, it's working out, and then it's eating right, and then it's taking your supplements, which is another reason again why you want to hire a trainer, because they're going to tell you the right supplements that you're going to be taking. Like, I take vitamin D, I take dandelion root, I take a fat burner, I take a multivitamin. I feel like I'm missing one, but there's a bunch of, like, I have like a pill case every day. I take a handful of pills along with my protein and everything else, and I really like, it's serious. So it's working out, it's eating right, it's your supplements, it's stretching, because that is another thing. I didn't realize how serious stretching was, especially with weightlifting, how important that is, because I've almost injured myself from not stretching enough. So that is another major thing that nobody tells you about. Like, you really gotta stretch all the time. Like, it's gotta be like a morning, night. Like, every time you think about it, like, just be stretching your muscles. Like, right now, I just did that, and I need to stretch. So make sure you're always stretching. And the last thing is rest. You have to be able to get sleep. All this team, no sleep. The hustle don't stop. We grinding, we, no. Like, you actually need 8 hours of sleep, because what my trainer explained to me is when you're sleeping and you're getting the proper rest, that's when you're losing the weight. When you're actually like doing the physical workouts and you're meal prepping and all of that, you're not losing the weight then, because everything's actually, is the exact opposite. Everything's like swelling. When you sleep, it gives your body an opportunity to rest and really burn all of those calories. And you burn more calories when you're sleeping than when you're awake, believe it or not. So definitely rest is a part of it. So working out is not the only thing. It's like working out along with like a whole other list of things that you have to do to see results and to be successful with this weight loss journey. The last few things that I want to mention, you want to have a game plan for your cravings and when you want to eat cheat meals. You want to have a game plan for that, because we're human. We still like our chips and salsa and our Mexican food and our Japanese food and things of that nature, but everything in moderation. And if you have a trainer, they can let you know, like, okay, you've been doing good for this week, or you lost this amount of body fat, this is a good time for you to have a cheat meal. They will plan it for you, and then you can go crazy. But you just don't want to be out here in these streets all willy-nilly just getting you Popeyes and Burger King every time you have a craving popped up. Like, you really have to be mindful of that and mindful of when you're eating the bad stuff, because it really does affect your body and how quickly you will see results. And let's be very clear, if you have a good trainer knows when you've been fucking up. A good trainer knows when you have not been on it and you've been eating too much salt or drink. I remember one night, and I can't even believe I tried to hide it from him, but I went out and I had a couple drinks. I came in to work out the next day, and as soon as I walked in, Jake looked at me and was like, "You was drinking last night, wasn't you?" And I did not look hungover. I wasn't hungover. He could just tell. Again, I still don't know how he figured that out, but he did. And so you want to be mindful of like drinking, eating bad, cheating. You can have all of those things, but have it planned, and definitely talk to your trainer or your accountability partner on what those days are and what that looks like. Okay. Have that like in place, like at the beginning of your workout journey, so that you know what to expect when it comes to that. Another good tip that you're gonna have to do, and it sucks, and it took me forever to finally get on board with this, but you have to track your food and you have to track your eating. The reason why you have to track what you eat is because it helps your trainer with your macros and, like, you know, how many carbs you're eating, how many grams of protein that you're eating, what they need to ram up on, what they need to tell you to cut out, add in. But they can't do that if they don't know what you're eating. So keeping a food journal, there's an app called MyFitnessPal that works amazing. Like, it's so awesome because on the app, you can just scan the barcode and like all the nutritional information. They take out all the guesswork. Like, you don't have to figure anything out. Just make sure you're tracking your food. Another thing that I wanted to mention, if you do have a moment of weakness and you have your cheat meal turn into a cheat day, turn into a cheat week, or whatever the case may be, don't stay there. This was my issue, and this was probably the main thing, the main reason why I was not successful for so many years, because I would have a couple of days where I wouldn't work out. I was eating what I wanted to eat, and I would say to myself, and I know y'all do it because I did it. I would say to myself, you know what? I think I'm good on the weight loss thing. Like, I fell off the wagon. I've been eating like crap, so I'll try again next month, or I'll try again in a couple of months, or, you know, my birthday's in a couple of months. After my birthday, I'll start back working out. Like, I would literally say that and do that, or, oh, the holidays are coming up and I know I'm gonna be one to pick out. Screw y'all, listen, that is the worst thing you could do, because it's just gonna make a long process even longer when you do that. Have your moments, have your Popeyes, have your Jimmy John's. Like, I really don't give a care. I don't. But what I want you guys to remember is, in that moment of weakness, when you fall down, most people, when they fall down, they get right back up. They don't stay there. And that's what you have to remember when you're on this journey. Okay, so you had the brownie. Okay, so you had the cheesecake. You had the whatever. Dust that off and continue on your journey. Screw it, because one good workout or two good workouts is gonna erase that anyway. So I really want you to focus on, not when you fall, don't focus on being on the ground. Focus on getting back up and staying consistent with this journey, because the results that it yields, you guys, it's the most amazing thing. And for me to be in the space that I'm in now, in a healthy space where I'm so conscious about what I'm eating and what I'm doing and me working out, I work out all the time now. Like, I'm like workout life, okay? And it's about to get even more intense, you know, with my journey that I'm embarking upon in the next week and a half. So all I want to say to you guys is, this is very possible. And I hope that I did not scare any of you guys out of starting a fitness journey. I just wanted to have a moment where I was candid, where I was real, and I was very honest about what to expect while on this journey. And I really just wanted to share my own personal thoughts and opinions about it. Just to make sure that you're successful, because if I had known all of this information ahead of time, I definitely would be like where I want to be already. But that's okay. And the reason why all of that happened is so that I can share my experience with you guys. So I'm not mad at it. I'm not mad that it took me as long as it did, so that you don't have to. Learn from my mistakes. Learn from what I'm doing and what I did in the past, and how I'm, and take from that, and then grow from it so that you can be successful on your weight loss journey. Y'all, it has been my absolute pleasure from the bottom of my heart to share this with you guys. I hope this helps. If it does, let me know, because I definitely want to talk to you guys and interact with you guys. So please leave all of your questions, your concerns, your comments in the comment section below. I'll be sure to respond to you guys. If you haven't already, please make sure you hit that like button, that subscribe button, and don't forget to turn on that notification bell so that you can be the first to know when I post new videos. As always, I love you all so, so, so much. Thank you for stopping by, and I can't wait to see you guys tomorrow. All right, bye.